Roberto Molina, an engineer, has been in quarantine since March. That's when his company suspended office activities because of the coronavirus. Since then, he hasn't left home for fear of the virus.
I'm afraid for my family. My concern is to be a vector and end up transmitting it to other people.
But Brazil's biggest cities, São Paulo and Rio de Janeiro, have reopened commercial activities, parks and gyms. Even though the country has registered an average of more than 1,000 deaths a day. Last weekend was the first time Dan Molina went outside. His choice? A restaurant.
It's like I'm doing something for the first time in my life, something brand new. I felt totally safe.
But less than 2 kilometers away, another reality. In a popular street market, overcrowding. To buy cheaper food, people put themselves at risk of infection. In just 20 minutes, Celita da Costa had contact with 3 vendors not wearing masks.
This is a lack of education and love for the others, because if I don't take care of myself, I'll spread disease, and so pandemic will never end.
Regional capitals like Porto Alegre and Curitiba were considered examples in coronavirus control at the beginning of the pandemic. The low number of deaths and cases led to a reopening in June, but it maybe have been too soon. Now hospitals in both cities have reached a limit of capacity.
Some states reopen economic activities and now the whole process had to go back a few steps because we remain in an accelerated phase of coronavirus. As much as we have reopened, we always need to look at the weekly data and build our slowly recovery, understanding the necessity of their economic retake.
Brazilian President Jair Bolsonaro, even after being diagnosed with COVID-19, continues to say the disease is just a little flu, for which nothing can be done.
What do you want me to do? My name is Messiah, but I can't work miracles.
Meanwhile, a coalition of Brazilian health workers has lodged a complaint against Bolsonaro at the International Criminal Court in The Hague, accusing him of genocide and crimes against humanity for his response to the pandemic. Edgar Maciel for VOA News, São Paulo.